few minutes. Eight minutes. Quiet, baby. Four minutes. Well, happy new.
Ever since Taylor started looking for a new cashback credit card, she's been freezing up.
I got this.
Or you can try NerdWallet, which has side-by-side comparisons to help find the best credit card for you.
Oh, we're finally doing this, are we? Because I was going to make a sandwich. Okay.
Fable?
Let's do it. What do I think about heroes? Well, we've all seen them, haven't we? Swanning about the place with their disproportionately high cheekbones and comically massive weapons.
Wanker.
Fable!
Roughing up bandits, because they like to rough up bandits, don't they? Living it up with the common folk every single night. On a day-to-day basis, I'd say the true hero's me, someone who's breaking new ground with fruit, with veg, on the agricultural side of things.
Just look at it's a big pumpkin.
Not wafting around mythical creatures.
Chicken!
And that's what they are. wafters.
Yeah, well done.
You see, I'm not here to slay legendary beasts. I'm here to conquer the vegetable, not a euphemism. Let's face it, the age of heroes is over. This is the age of innovation. This, if you will, is the age of death. One moment. This is awkward.
Yeah. Oh.
World premiere.
Death don't have no mercy in this land. Death don't have no mercy in this land. He'll come to your house and it won't stay long. You look in the bed and somebody'll be gone. Death don't have no mercy.
Shaking bones. Been a while. So, you remember that favor you owe me? I'm looking for a creature. Huge, sneaky. Teeth like knives. No? Well, hey, how about you guys? No? Nobody? Not helpful. Mm-hmm. Sneaky.
These are dangerous times. At least, that's what I hear. The Empire? They're everywhere. But the world here belongs to the Syndicates. If I want to survive, I have to play their game. Looks like I'm all in.
She's in here somewhere.
On second thought, I'm out.
There she is.
finally be free. Wherever that takes me.
I'm here to offer you a way out, okay?
Get off my ship, Jaylen.
Give me a chance. You're gonna have to trust me. It'll be dangerous, risky. But if you pull this off, you'll never look over your shoulder again.
The underworld shows no mercy. But it's a big galaxy out there, and I'm gonna risk it all.
South of Midnight, Star Wars Outlaws. Welcome to our first ever double feature, the Xbox Game Showcase, followed by a deep dive into one of the most important RPGs ever made, Starfield. Gaming is the most powerful of all entertainment. It transports, it challenges, it connects us, and it's just incredibly and awesomely fun. That is why Team Xbox is committed to building the greatest place to play. By partnering with the most ambitious of game creators, and by unleashing the power of the gaming community, enabling all of us to play the games we want with our friends anywhere, from mobile devices to PCs to consoles. The lineup we have for you today is just incredible. These are the works of the very greatest creative teams from around the world. We made this show for you. The largest, most engaged, and globally diverse fan base in Xbox history. You are the heart and soul of Xbox. Your passion drives us, and you are the inspiration for the visionaries whose games we showcase today. From me and all of the team at Xbox, thank you. This next game is from Thunder Lotus, the award-winning studio behind Spiritfarer, who've gone back to their combat roots with an amazing co-op raid-focused action game that is uniquely theirs. All right, everybody, it's time.
World premiere.
Three-person co-op?
Guys, it's a steady job. Just in and out. Nothing to it.
Everybody hit the floor.
Yes!
Awesome.
World premiere.
Ooh, Atlas. Hey, Mad Dog. I have Payday 2. Oh, on the Epic Store? Yeah, I have it for my Xbox. Persona. That looks cool. How are you?
People don't like you very much, do they? Sent here to the Living Lands by an emperor who couldn't bother to come himself. To investigate some plague that seems to be corrupting our very souls. Us to trust you, but the truth is,
yeah, I can't wait for Starfield.
You scare us. Oh, the way you fight, the power you wield, the secrets you keep. You're either here to save us.
Oh, this is gonna be awesome.
Or destroy us. But now that you have all this power, what are you gonna do with it?
Yes.
Welcome to the Scum
Bar. No way.
The most notorious tavern on Melee Island. Wall to wall rogues and scum.
Cool.
So tell me, which ship is right for you? A big ship? A luxury ship? A ship with just a splash of je ne sais quoi?
The legend of Monkey Island? You mean Governor Guybrush. But Freefoot's not set foot out of that mansion for almost a year.
Hey, what do you think you're doing? I told you no autographs. Though I see you have a meet and greet ticket. And I guess it's not every day that you get to meet the mighty pirate Guybrush Threepwood.
Cool.
The legend of Monkey Island.
The Chuck has turned the memories of this island into a prison for Guybrush.
Well, well, what do we have here?
You need these.
Things may be very different from the sea of thieves you know.
Hold on!
Awesome! Cool!
That's awesome.
World premiere.
Hi, Melina here, speaking to you from our performance capture stage at Ninja Theory,
where we have just wrapped our shoots for Senua Saga Hellblade 2. When we first showed gameplay for Hellblade 2, it was a look at some of the game's cinematic and immersive action, where Senua faced off against a gigantic troll on the Icelandic coastline. Today, we're taking you deeper into Senua's story, her personal quest, her unique perspective on the world, and the intimate journey that awaits you in Senua Saga. What you'll see today is all captured by the team on Xbox Series X.
She can feel them slipping through her soul, following the threads of her mind. She's here to find them, the ones who hide. She needs their help with a promise, a question. But it's never so simple, is it? Wisdom has a price. And there's always a part of you that changes. A part of you that darkens. And a part of you that dies.
Over there, that pool. I can feel them.
I can feel them everywhere. The lost ones.
They are watching us.
I will not let them down.
She is ready.
Oh.
どこだここ。
Oh, turns up, dude. Yeah, dude. Hang loose, bro.
What? 俺がどうかしたのか? Huh? 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 Huh?
Wonderland of promise plucked from post-atomic blight. The fruit of years of prudent progress and determined reclamation and 15 million dwellers worth of keen imagination. From the heart of West Virginia to the depths of the pit.
Well, we owe it all to Vault 76.
No matter if you roam alone or spend your time with friends, you'll find a home in Appalachia where the good times never end. There are relics to uncover from a time before the war, along with loads of friendly folks to meet and enemies galore. Our world is always changing. Greater foes are overthrown as we embark on expeditions into thrilling new unknowns. Yes, from Appalachian settlements to Nuka World on tour. You're never short on things to do or places to explore. Think you've seen it all, eh? Well, how about this? Pack your bags for an escape of Epicurean bliss. Put your rad shield on and fix your hair up pretty because we're headed for the boardwalk of Atlantic City. So there you have it. Now you know there's a million ways to make the wasteland your waste home. And when you hear adventure calling, when you're looking for some kicks...Answer the call of Vault 76.
Cool.
Play it now with Xbox Game Pass.
Cool.
World premiere.
General Motors' historic commitment to performance is embodied in two of its iconic brands, Chevrolet and Cadillac. The V-Series.R elevates Cadillac's competitive spirit to a whole new level with its thunderous V8 and hybrid power. The legendary Corvette has been a celebrated champion for decades. The all-new Chevrolet Corvette E-Ray continues that tradition. General Motors is proud to usher in a new era of competition with the innovators behind the new Forza Motorsport.
Forza Motorsport and General Motors are pairing their strengths in technical excellence and sophisticated modern design to take bold steps into the future and bring that experience to gamers. I'm thrilled to welcome the Cadillac V-Series.R and the Corvette E-Ray to the home of competition.
I know you're ready. You've got this. Let's tweak the car's performance for the next one. I'm feeling the vibe, taking my time light. Deep in the maze, making my shine bright. Whoa, I gotta make it, I'm going sky high. Never hold back, right, 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 right. Yeah, I'm rolling, fuck, fuck, fuck. Your best lap yet. This is my timeline.
Seen all that ever was and all that ever will be. I have seen betrayal, endurance, ambition, and courage. I am the one who knows. Disconnected from fate's flow. Unseen forces move against me, hungry for forbidden knowledge. A mystery long kept hidden. A secret that threatens to unravel reality itself.
Cesus Unit 37. Toronto is under attack.
By Null Sector.
There's something different about Null Sector this time.
They've taken over most of the city, and they're rounding up Omnics.
They need our help.
People are answering Winston's recall. There's new blood on the team. And we have so much to teach them.
If we can stop Null Sector, maybe we can save the city.
Coming through.
Been a while, Vivian.
As if I didn't have enough problems already.
So we fly up there, smash through anything that gets in our way, and hoax another business.
I hate to interrupt the moment, but I'm picking up reports of more attacks in other cities.
It's a fight they want. I say let's give it to them.
Time to create peace with bullets.
Wicked!
Greetings.
Oh, yeah! Boom!
The world is counting on us.
Let's go.
Shall we do this together?
Fight with me!
Engaging.
Watch this!
I saw that. Not bad.
World premiere.
What is this place?
It looks like we're in a palace.
What the hell is going on?
Who are these people?
No idea. But if they're attacking us, our only choice is fighting back.
Hey, look over there!
Can you get us out of here?
So you're telling me you're thieves who steal hearts, and you just happen to stumble into this world? The Rebel Corps will always help the Phantom Thieves, just as the Phantom Thieves have helped the Rebel Corps. Never forget that we're a united force who can rely on each other.
Cool.
You should be grateful to have been made my subjects, but you're just matterless little brats!
Unfortunately, returning will be no easy feat.
Somewhere deep inside, I know you realize things can't go on like this. So, will you take a stand beside us?
Yeah! Let's show them what we got!
Humanity has always hunted for knowledge in the unknown. The wonder is, not that the field of stars is so vast, but that we have measured it. We're all here because we're committed to the biggest question of all. What's out there? You're part of Constellation now. Part of our family.
We do not fully understand all that is at work here.
No finer group in the stars to be unraveling this mystery.
I'll follow you from here on out, Captain.
Grab jump is ready. I love this part.
These artifacts could be everything we've been looking for. Another great secret the universe is asking us to unravel. Human settlements throughout the galaxy could be at risk. We are not stopping. Whatever lies at the end of this road will change humanity forever. This is where we belong.
Emmanuel,
Hi. I'm very excited to be returning as Johnny Silverhand in the upcoming expansion for Cyberpunk 2077, Phantom Liberty. This new adventure reunites Johnny and V on a dangerous spy mission and introduces Idris Elba as secret agent Solomon Reed. It's really amazing to share the screen with you, Idris. It's cool to be a part of this game with you, man. As a player, you'll get to visit Dogtown, an unexplored part of Night City, and rescue the president of the new United States of America. Expect a massive expansion, twists, secrets, and plenty of stuff to do. I know the team at CD Projekt Red just keeps raising the bar when it comes to telling cinematic stories in video games. And I really can't wait for you to play it on Xbox Series X and S. But enough talking. I'm guessing you want to see for yourself. And so it is my honor and pleasure to give you and introduce the official trailer for Phantom Liberty. Check it out.
There's got to be a way out of this.
Johnny, I'm dying. There's nothing can stop that.
V. My name is Songbird. I'm an NUS intelligence analyst. I know about the bomb ticking in your head. And I can save your life.
What's the catch?
I need you to get to Dogtown.
Attention all Dogtown residents. The president managed to crash her Space Force One into our humble district.
Man's got 1,001 reasons to want Myers as a hostage. Sleeper agents. Time to wake them up.
So NUSA's tossing us back into the fray, huh?
Stay sharp. We're in the wolf's den now.
Get Myers out of there.
Time to evac.
Her safety is the top priority.
Shit!
They catch us out here, we're dead. Wait, hear that?
God almighty, it's moving! Run! This way, quick!
Someone ratted us out.
You know, V, treason ain't ever black and white.
It's a charade, V.
Wherever she goes, people get hurt. Bodies drop.
Just want what Songbird promised me. The cure.
Situation's changed. Need to know if you're with me.
Illusion of freedom draws in the desperate. Pick your truth, V.
Come on. Got iron in your hand. Gotta put it to someone's head. Pull the trigger.
Do anything and do it soon. I'll die.
premiere.
Boku o oboeteru ka?
Kokumin no shintaku o motto mo atsumeshi mono ga tsumi naru o to naru shikaku o eru mono to suru.
Heika no oinochi ga ubawareru nado.
Nanji, sadame o kaserare shi koyo, urei o kakaeru tabibito ni.
Koitsu ga ore no gaisensha da!
Hatashite dare ga tsugi no ou ka?
Onore jishin ni meiji nasai. 内なる英雄の姿に変われと。
真の王を志すならば、打ち勝ってみせよ。
僕のいる世界の出来事は、君にとっては絵空のと。
まさか、人間？
この国は今、有史以来の危機にさらされている。
どうやら面白い力を手にしたようだ。
主君に捧げると決めた覚悟そのものだ。
これこそ人間の真実だ。
道は二つに一つ。
またあったね。やはり君は興味深い。
今こそあんた自身がそうなる前よ。
正義かどうかじゃない。
誰もが恐れと不安に負けそうで。
理想を貫け。
何が正しいのかわからない。
全ての始まりはあなたの持つ小説。
幻想はただの絵空事なんかじゃない。
That looks interesting. I guess.
World premiere.
Humanity's cities have fallen. Our people's only means of survival is to seek sanctuary here.In the Belfry. You must explore this world to find the origins of this evil. And bring hope back to our people. Together, you can save humanity.
Cool. Cool.
World premiere.
City is a miracle of progress. A finely tuned, delicately balanced machine. But it only takes one rebellious little gear to ruin everything.If you resist my rule, if you alter our past, if you threaten what I have built, There is nowhere in space or time where I will not destroy you. What did I do?
Any last words before my friend puts one in your scalp?
Cool! That looks awesome!
Thank you all for joining us. Today is a special day for me and the team. I'm excited to see 11 games showcased from our first party studios. We opened with Fable from Playground Games, which will bring the franchise into the modern era while staying true to its British style and humor. Compulsion and In Exile shared their first original experiences since joining Xbox with South of Midnight and Clockwork Revolution. And we are thrilled at how Avowed is shaping up for release next year from the RPG masters at Obsidian. In addition to Avowed, our studios will deliver Hellblade 2, an all-new Microsoft Flight Simulator, Towerborn, and more in 2024. Later this month, players can look forward to Elder Scrolls Online Necrom and Sea of Thieves Monkey Island. As we look to holiday, we will launch Starfield and Forza Motorsport, both built for Xbox Series X, S, and PC. We are also honored to share 14 games today from our creative partners, like Star Wars Outlaws from Ubisoft Massive in collaboration with Lucasfilm Games, 33 Immortals from Thunder Lotus, Kunitsu Gami, Path of the Goddess from Capcom, and more Persona games coming to Game Pass thanks to our continued partnership with Sega Atlas. I'd also like to congratulate the Studio Zero team on Metaphor ReFantazio. It's great to be able to premiere what is next from the creators of Persona here in our showcase. We are focused on putting our players and game creators first in everything we do. No matter if you choose to play on Xbox, PC, or over the cloud, all gamers are welcome here at Xbox. When it comes to our consoles, we have heard your feedback on two fronts. First, we have significantly increased our supply of Xbox Series X, making it easier for fans to find globally. Second, we know you've wanted more storage with Xbox Series S, and I'm excited to share we have some news there as well. And now for the one more thing you've all been waiting for. Prepare for the most comprehensive deep dive we've ever done for the biggest game we've ever built. So sit tight and enjoy Starfield Direct.
everyone. Thank you so much for joining us today, and welcome to Bethesda Game Studios. You know, we've been so lucky over the decades to make the kind of games that we love here, and that's thanks to all of you, from The Elder Scrolls to Fallout. We love creating these worlds and playing in them just as much as you do. And throughout all that time, we'd often talk about and dream up the space game. What if we could take that feeling of being who you want to be and exploring a new world, but set it in space, where you weren't really limited in where you could go or what you could do? And that is Starfield. Obviously, we've come a long way since then. With the games we've built, our technology, and all of us here in the studio, we've done so much together, but, well, we've never tried to make a game like this. Today, you'll get to hear from many on the team and see so much of what we think makes our game special. So let's jump in and take a look. Starfield is our first new universe in over 25 years, but it's still a Bethesda RPG through and through, where you step into a new world and you get that feeling of unlimited possibilities. But this time, it's not just one world. It's over 1,000 worlds. Because the choice of where to go, it's not ours, it's yours. And it wasn't until now that we had the technology to create it. From the rocks at your feet, to the mountains in the distance, to the people and creatures that live in these worlds. That isn't just a backdrop. That moon is actually there orbiting the planet. Yes, you can visit it too. We realistically simulate the galaxy around you. Our next generation lighting model uses real-time global illumination to light the world based on the type of star and the makeup of the planet's atmosphere. We also have an all-new animation system. And of course, you can play it in third person, and you can play it in first person. We love exploration and rewarding it, but you do explore differently in this game, given its scale. That usually involves exploring an area you've landed in. You can collect resources, do a mission, and maybe even stumble upon something unexpected. We do love stuff and all of the items allowing you to pick everything up, and you can view all that in your data menu. This is the hub for everything you're doing, from your skills to your ship, your missions, and your inventory. We love to pack a ton of detail in every object, from all of your weapons to spacesuits to food. We just obsess over the details and food. We obsess over food. When you're done exploring, you can walk back or fast travel to your ship. We have companions and crew you can take with you. I left Vosko here back at my ship.
Welcome back, cool. Captain Howard.
And he can even
That's
say your
awesome.
Name. Let's head out.
Our mission was to convey the wonder and majesty of space exploration, to evoke the romance of the golden age of early spaceflight. And we've been referring to this approach as NASA Punk. This means a design language where the tech is advanced, yet still looks grounded and relatable.
For us, it's that contrast. That's where the visual interest is. Obviously the NASA, which is the rigid, hard function over style, and then Punk, which is all about style.
You can see that visual style coming through in your ship. Your ship is your home for you and your crew. And like many of the spaces in our game, it has a slightly retro and analog touch, a bit of lo-fi rather than sci-fi, where everything is well used, worn, and lived in.
Alrighty. What's the plan, Captain?
This is your star map. It starts with the planet you're currently on. You can see all of its info and resources. You can choose a landing spot or fast travel to known locations. Backing out further, you can view all the planets in the system. Obviously, the game is big, and it's here you can see planets that have key locations, missions, or life on them, versus the many planets that are barren but resource-heavy. Zoom out even further to see all the systems in this part of the galaxy. Here, you can plot a course to ones that are light years away. This uses your ship's grav drive to fold space and jump to these systems. And you will need to upgrade your ship and skills if you want to jump to the most distant ones. But for now, we'll plot a course to the Alpha Centauri system where we can find the city of New Atlantis.
City like New Atlantis, your eyes are guided upwards to just these boundless, vast buildings.
It's the biggest city we've ever made, not just in size, but also in the amount of custom art, crowds, and quests.
So the main focus when we're designing a city is obviously what supports the story. We try and tell as many small stories as possible.
This is a Colony War memorial.
It's a few moments of gameplay that make the space feel like it's full of real characters that are going about their day-to-day lives.
It's paralyzing if you really stop and think about it.
Buddy, it's coffee.
It's also where your adventure with Constellation begins.
Welcome to Constellation. We have a lot to talk about.
By the time you meet them, Constellation is sort of seen as this mythical group. Most people don't even know they exist anymore. They're the last true explorers in the galaxy, and they're trying to find the answers to some of humanity's biggest questions.
The artifacts are so different, so alien, and I'm certain one of them reached out and spoke to you. The artifact. If you could place it on the table here.
Oh my god, look at how it's coming together.
That means there's a set.
Built by an intelligence outside the settled systems.
It's definitely an eclectic cast of characters. You've got Sarah Morgan, the ex-soldier and adventurer, now Constellation's leader. Mateo, the theologian who believes that there's definitely something else out there. Noel, the gifted scientist and Sarah Morgan's protege. And Walter, a very successful businessman in the settled systems and Constellation's financier.
Anything goes as long as you have the money.
There's also Vlad, the ex-pirate, Sam Coe, the former space cowboy, and Barrett.
You know what I hate about these pirates? Completely resistant to my otherwise irresistible charm.
The journey you take with Constellation is just the first of many you'll embark on. The Settled Systems is home to all kinds of different stories, people, and adventures for you to uncover. The United Colonies is where you'll find New Atlantis, the first major human settlement in space. The people who live here value law, discipline, and the legacy of humanity. They consider themselves the true children of Earth.
You ever think of joining up with the Vanguard? Help the United Colonies, even get your UC citizenship?
New Atlantis isn't the only city within the United Colonies. The city of Cydonia on Mars to this day serves as the largest mining facility for the United Colonies. beyond the United Colonies' reach, you might find yourself in a much more wild and independent coalition of star systems. This is Freestar Collective Space. The capital of the Freestar Collective is Aquila City.
The Stone Root Inn is an Aquila City fixture.
A ranger relies on judgment and intuition to do what's best for the people.
Duels?
Neon started out as a fishing platform, but is now known throughout the settled systems as a pleasure city where almost anything goes.
If you've got morality issues, this definitely isn't the job for you.
Ryujin is hiring the best and brightest of today for our future tomorrow.
Everyone has been chewed up and ground up by Neon. Try not to get yourself killed, all right?
Outside the bounds of civilized space, there are still plenty of unclaimed systems to explore, but these areas are also home to the most hostile factions in the galaxy.
The great serpent hungers. All heathens shall be made dust in time.
A new face. This is the face of a brave runner here to challenge the Red Mile.
They think the galaxy is theirs. They are wrong. It belongs to the Crimson Fleet. It always has.
In Starfield, we're pushing our cities and settlements further than we ever have before. It's all there, waiting for you. A slice of humanity's future.
So, ready to get out there?
Throughout the galaxy, there are so many things to see and stories to experience. But the most important story is the one that you tell. I'm the type of person who spends hours in character creation, and I think people are going to be really excited when they see all of the improvements we've made.
One of the biggest overhauls was done through our character generation system.
We scanned a wide range of faces from different age groups and ethnicities. And by mixing and matching all that data, we were able to create highly detailed and diverse characters.
We use that exact system to create all of the characters and NPCs you're going to see in the game. So any character you see always is a character you could make yourself.
Not all of it.
Hey, come on. Come on. Okay, take it easy. You were out cold. No physical damage. Mentally, the jury's still out. You know who you are? New recruit for Argos Extractors? Ring any bells? Any of this look familiar?
Whoa!
You start your character creation journey as though you're cycling through employee records. You'll pick from a lineup of 40 presets, and that'll be your starting point. Your journey from there can be as detailed or as quick as you want it to be. This new system has more to offer than ever before.
It's also the simplest character generation system we ever had. We let the player get as close as possible to make whatever they want. With the various facial morphs you can blend together, the dermesthetic and makeup, blemishes, scars, piercings, teeth settings, it's a lot, but I think it's the most fun to use.
Character creation is more than just how you look. This is also where you start to decide who you want to be. That's where backgrounds come in. Backgrounds give you a bit of backstory and start you out with three basic skills.
From chef to dusty. You know, the crew still has a betting pool about which restaurant critic you must have crossed to wind up here.
What's great about backgrounds is you never know when yours is going to come in handy. You could be in the middle of a fancy restaurant, talking to some guy, and suddenly you learn he needs a beast hunter to help track down a monster.
Fine. I probably should stick to professionals anyway, given what happened the last time.
We're also giving you the option to customize your build even further by letting you pick up to three traits. Traits are completely optional, and they come with their own advantages and disadvantages. You could choose to meet your biggest fan.
By the terror! Is it really, really you?
He'll join your crew, and he'll give you gifts, if you're willing to put up with his constant commentary.
I can't believe I get to stand near you, breathing like the same air.
I've got to have every molecule.
My favorite trait is kid stuff. You have to pay some credits to support your parents, but they're very sweet, and it's really fun to go visit them.
Honey, we got ourselves a visitor.
Oh, my God.
I came across some hostile zealots in space, but because I had chosen a trait that made me the same religion as them, I was able to get by without any issues.
Whoa!
There's another great one that gives you a damage buff when your health is low, but mercenaries will randomly show up and try to kill you.
Cool!
No matter what you choose, there will be plenty of ways for you to tell your story. And if you want to remove a trait, there are ways to do that too.
What a view! It's a feast for the eyes! Off we go to another adventure!
We'll let you discover that on your own.
Once you've built the perfect character, that's when your journey can really begin. We took what we loved about skills and perks from our previous games and put them together to create an all-new skill system.
Each time you level up, you get a skill point, which can be used to unlock or rank up skills. Ranks are unlocked by completing challenges associated with that skill. Challenges become increasingly difficult as you work your way to higher ranks. With our 5 different skill trees and 4 ranks per skill, there's a lot to choose from.
I like the Xenosociology skill because it lets you mind control aliens.
What?
Boost pack, out of the gate. I'm boost packing everywhere.
I like maxing out my physical tree so I can get neuro strikes and just punch my way through combat.
That's amazing!
That one's a lot of fun.
Invest in the skills that suit your playstyle.
I'm very much a stealth player. So, I'm out there pickpocketing everyone. My favorite part about being stealthy is slowly creeping through vents like you're in a movie. And then jumping out and springing on people?
Whenever possible, I like to talk my way through situations.
This area's off limits.
Fine, I'll issue you an access card.
I'm more of a run-and-gun player. I like doing the death from above thing where I boost pack over guys and I throw landmines at them.
What?
I like blowing stuff up.
Exploration is a key aspect of all our games. In Starfield, there are full star systems with new life, resources, and adventures. Our team worked hard to strike a balance between fun and realism. We studied data from NASA and a multitude of other sources to help us make the world feel believable. From the way we approached planetary atmospheres to the way we placed biomes based on the planet's distance from the sun. Once we had created a grounded world, we could start looking at all the things that make that world fun. When you leave a planet and head into space, you'll be navigating asteroid fields, having chance meetings with interesting strangers, dogfighting in space, and exploring derelict ships. It's all out there. Ultimately, it's about rewarding your curiosity, because whether it's on the surface of a planet, the alleys of a city, or the vastness of space, you never know what you'll find.
Space exploration is possible thanks to your ship.
Your ship is almost like having another character or home you can make all your own. I think you'll be blown away by the amount of stuff you can do. You can buy a ship.
I'm sure you can find something you like.
Customize and upgrade that ship. And hire a crew to keep it up and running.
Cool!
And it all starts in spaceports. Every spaceport has a ship technician where you can purchase, sell, and modify ships.
Anything I can help you with?
Maybe you start off with a speedy fighter that's perfect for bounty hunting. Then you might round out your ship roster with a hulking space freighter to run cargo missions, or even do a little smuggling. For now, though, we're going to take our starting ship, the Frontier, and make some changes. You can customize and upgrade everything you see here. And you have two ways to do that. You can quickly upgrade individual systems, like your weapons or shields, or you can deep dive and enter the ship builder mode. Here you can change anything, from the systems to the look and layout. Adding a new habitat module can give you more room for crew. Adding cowling can change your ship's overall silhouette. An improved grav drive allows for longer distance space jumps. You can even fully customize your paint job to get the exact look you want. The parts you choose to build with don't just affect your ship's stats. They'll also affect what you can do inside your ship. You can have modules for crafting or for storing and displaying your weapons. Starfield's in-game ship manufacturers bring their own look and feel to every piece of your ship. From living quarters to cargo holds, mess halls, and control rooms. Our modified Frontier is a practical ship, but with a little creativity, your ship can look like almost anything you want.
It's a bit odd, but one of my favorite ways of customizing ships is I make them look like animals. The HMS Platypus, as I called it, where it had a giant tail to it. And we've done spiders, we've done mechs. So it's really whatever your imagination is.
And cool. While you can build your home among the stars the way you want to, you're probably not the only person who will call your ship home.
Ready to lift off when you are, Captain.
Engines ready.
The Frontier is fueled and ready, Captain.
Some of the members of Constellation can join you on your journey. These companions can serve on your crew, and they'll always be there when you travel.
We'll be traveling together until we either find an artifact or this lead runs dry.
Each companion comes with their own valuable skills for your ships and outposts, as well as unique quest lines. Eventually, some friendships might blossom into romance.
I don't know that I've ever really loved anyone except you.
And if you're looking for a little extra help on your ship, you can always hire additional crew at spaceports.
Got any room on your ship for someone like me?
Cool.
You'll also meet potential crew members out in the world.
Still think there might be a spot for me on your ship? I gotta get off this rock.
Assign crew to your ship or outposts, and their unique skills will affect how they run. And just like companions, most crew members can lend a hand in the field. Take Bosco, for instance.
He's designed around the core basics of a NASA machine.
Please avoid getting shot. You might die.
I still want to give it almost a humanoid personality, so I elongated the limbs. This tends to make him feel more human-like and give him a little personality.
It is a shame.
Amazing.
Exploration requires so much bloodshed.
Using the ship-building tools and crew selection features in Starfield, you'll be able to build and captain the ship of your dreams. And now, let's take to the sky. We're putting you in the cockpit of your very own spaceship and telling you that you can do
pretty much anything. And that is really cool for us as developers. Spaceflight should be exciting and dangerous. And you should feel like you're in complete control every step of the way. We've extended that sense of control to ship combat. It's not about just hitting your triggers to fire your weapons. It's a complex dance between your piloting skills and our power allocation system. Boosting power to your engines will make your ship faster. Powering up the grav drives will shorten the amount of time it takes before you can make a jump. And moving your power to your weapons and shields means you're ready for a fight. You should always be on your toes because you're not alone out there. Unlocking the targeting control system skill will allow you to zero in on specific subsystems of the ship you target. After destroying an enemy ship, you can loot the remains from your cockpit. You can always turn any ship that engages you into scrap. But you can also take a more personal approach by docking with the enemy vessel and boarding their ship.
Yes! Oh, hell yeah!
Once you've taken control of an enemy ship, it's yours. Add it to your fleet and retrieve it at any spaceport. But space is way more than fighting for your life. Just like when you're planetside, there are plenty of sights to see and stops to make on the way to your next adventure. Like these massive star yards. Walk the halls, talk to the crew, maybe get talked into buying a whole new ship.
A civilian in my star yard. Let's see about getting you a proper ship, one worthy of you.
Maybe you'll dock with a gigantic battleship, like the UC Vigilance. Or rub elbows with the galaxy's wealthy elite on a cruise ship fit for the stars.
Whoa.
There are plenty of personal encounters to be had as well. You can hail any ship you come across to trade, swap info, or maybe even commit an act of piracy.
Let's do this.
When I'm playing, I generally go crazy. I definitely go like the more piracy routes. I want to take over ships. I'm going to board ships. I'm like, this is now mine. I steal all the sandwiches and put them, you know, in my cargo hold that I have specifically for sandwiches. I don't want to play the hero, but I want to go out and just start taking things from people as quickly as possible.
That's some amazing. Strangers might be looking for a little human connection in the darkness of space.
Hello, stranger. I just finished cooking up some food. If you want to come on over, just pop on by.
Some of the best moments are the ones you discover on your own. The thing I love most about Starfield is that it is a Bethesda game through and through. It's really about going to strange new places, meeting interesting people, and getting sidetracked on zany adventures. Then, realizing 2 hours later that you're involved in a completely new story.
You're human. We thought we were the only ones to leave Earth.
That DNA is so present here. It's in our random encounters, it's in our handcrafted quests. And it feels so cool to play it and just make your own path in this universe. There are over 1,000 planets out there just waiting for you to visit. We want you to feel like explorers, breaking ground on new planets, exploring every inch of a mostly untouched galaxy. We want you to feel hopeful. We want you to feel this sense of awe and wonder. And sometimes, a little fear. We're giving you a massive playground and a ton of toys, and just setting you free.
Hey, everybody, we've shown you so much stuff, but we thought we'd just take a little break and show you something a little bit different. You know, we put so much detail into our game worlds, and we love the opportunity to bring that into the real world with our collector's editions. And for this game, we've done a watch. It is the Constellation Explorer's Watch. This is the watch that you actually get in the game that acts as part of your HUD, where it's the compass and then environmental information. It connects to your phone to give you notifications and other information. And we've also designed this really cool case that it comes with, Istvan.
Yeah, we really took as much care and designed this case as we did the watch. Our attention to detail in the game totally translates to this. Inspired by the cases that the astronauts used during the Apollo era to bring back samples from the moon. It's got an intricate locking mechanism, authentic, heavy, comes with a Constellation patch, NATO strap, and the overall functionality and believability of this as something that would exist in the world, in the Starfield universe.
Oh, and hey, take this. You'll find it very useful out there, and it even tells the time.
We actually have something else. Now that we're part of Xbox, we get to work with the amazing people on the Xbox hardware team, and together we have created this custom limited edition Starfield controller. It's awesome. It is now, you know, our favorite controller.
We love this because it's inspired by the actual controls of your spaceship. And not only that, we've created the first ever custom headset with Xbox. And this is a perfect pairing with that controller.
What?
In every one of our games, we always put so much care into all those little details that breathe life into our worlds. But Starfield isn't just a Bethesda Game Studios world, it's a Bethesda Game Studios galaxy. So why go this big with Starfield? Because we want to give you freedom on a galactic level. The freedom to experience both the exciting planets and the quiet ones. Scanning a planet before you land is a great way to get a sneak peek at the available resources you can use for crafting, building, and customizing.
I think what's cool about this whole system that we generate the planet itself as a procedural content, but the handcrafted content itself comes as the player explore. Our system builds a planet as the player approaches it. We stitch together a block of terrain. After that, we have the system that adds interesting locations for the player to explore, creatures to encounter, ore and plants to pick up. It allows us to add that touch of environmental storytelling that Bethesda is known for.
Aggressive creatures have been disrupting our experiments. Their habitat isn't far from here. If you could take care of them for us, we would be in your debt.
So even if your friends were to visit the same planet that you had, you would have a different story to tell.
It's completely up to you how you want to interact with each planet, whether you want to explore and see what you can find, harvest resources and be on your way, or simply take in the views. With the help of your scanner, you'll chart the uncharted and discover exotic wildlife.
If you
have the skills. You can even figure out that certain creatures and plants, you can build an outpost and produce resources from those plants and animals. You can get experience and rewards for fully surveying planets and fully surveying a whole system.
When we were concepting these creatures, we really wanted to think of them as natural to the environment. We didn't want alien monsters. We wanted native wildlife. Something you've never seen before.
When it comes to our exteriors, when the sun moves, all that light is calculated in real time through the atmosphere. Our biggest goal for lighting with Starfield was to make the game feel more filmic, to use lighting and color to really make it feel more cinematic.
After some exploring, you can find a spot to set up a base camp. Outposts can be built almost anywhere on any planet. And the habitat modules come in all shapes and sizes, filling all different purposes. You can even live in them. Assign crew and companions to work at your outposts for added bonuses and set up extractors to harvest resources while you're away.
Something cool we have this time is we have a new fly cam, where you can toggle between on-foot building, or you can now use a top-down isometric camera, which helps plan out larger parts of the outpost and placing those larger pads.
Oh, that's cool.
So that way you can really plan your structures and what the overall feel of your outpost is. And then when you're on your feet, you can really decorate and fine-tune things much easier.
Add crafting and research stations in your outpost to utilize any resources you find or already have.
Mod your weapons to adapt them to your playstyle. Different weapon sights and scopes, larger magazines, a selection of grips and barrels, different ammunition like explosive rounds. All you stealth players out there will surely need a suppressor.
Yes!
You can also choose to go hands-on with melee weapons.
I think it's always a delicate balance between, like, what's realistic, what's sim, and what's Hollywood. And I think we sort of err on the side of, like, what's fun for the player.
With Starfield, we've completely overhauled our combat. It's more dynamic, the animations are more fluid. It just feels great.
We probably have more mods and more weapons in this game than, I want to say, any other game we've done before. There's a lot of variety.
Upgraded gear is just one of the many factors to pay attention to when engaging in combat. You may need to switch things up based on your environment. Gravity is different for each planet, and boost packs are excellent for getting around and for giving you an edge in combat. Sometimes you'll even feel like you're flying.
Oh, that's amazing.
Zero gravity environments pose a different challenge. Firing a ballistic weapon in zero G will actually push you backwards. Energy weapons, on the other hand, offer a more stable shooting experience.
We also have mag weapons. These are high-powered electromagnetic induction ballistic arrays. Each barrel has its own targeting laser and can dish out some serious damage. Whether you want to get up close and personal with your own two fists, Or you like more compact weapons like pistols and submachine guns. Or maybe you prefer something bigger.
Oh! Yeah!
Starfield's got you covered.
Thanks again for being with us today. We are just so grateful that you've taken the time and spent it here. I know there was probably a lot to take in. There's a lot to the game, even more than we could show here. You know, as we play it, we're always sharing these unique and special moments that only a game like this can bring. When I think about what makes it special, it really is the people here. This game is a reflection of the incredible and passionate team that made it. All of them putting something special of themselves into it. So let's hear some of their favorite moments.
I love the way that our final combination of all the new tech has come together to create some of the most beautiful sunsets and sunrises we've ever had in any of our games.
I love the creatures, the exploration, every biome is different. The word that comes to mind is vast.
I like to use our photo mode to take rock star photos.
I just love that constant feel of discovery and wow, I can't believe that there's more here.
I'm most excited about our outpost building systems.
My favorite part is every time you step out on a planet, it's a unique experience.
You spend all this time building your ship and you see it on the landing pad. These things are gigantic. It's the kind of thing that you just can't get anywhere else.
There's something about seeing a tower over in the distance and going, I know the gravity's low here. I think I can make that jump.
My favorite part is biomes, spaceships,
audio design,
planets,
the day-night cycle.
Those details matter to me.
Diplomacy, exploration,
freedom,
the ending.
Beska, obviously.
I love the robot so much.
The incredible amount of worlds we created.
Sniper rifles, come on.
Lever action, rocket launcher.
Brain sprout.
I love, but some people might find creepy. I don't know. I know what's wrong, Ben.
The thing that I enjoy most about the game is the freedom to be who you want to be, do what you want to do. It's what you've come to expect from a Bethesda title, but on a much bigger scale.
On behalf of all of us, we can't wait for you to play Starfield and make your own special moments.
Damn, that was awesome. That was amazing. Damn, that was awesome. Alright, everybody, thanks for watching. That showcase and direct was awesome. So thanks for watching, everybody. I'll be back tomorrow with Ubisoft's conference around noon.